At this point, I would like to bring up another Salam's great brainchild. Side by side with ICTP, he also created the Academy of Science for the Developing World, to us, that I have briefly mentioned before. It was created some 27 years ago as the Third World Academy of Science at the time when Eastern Europe was still known as Second World. It's no longer there. So the name became somewhat anachronic. With due respect to Salam, we were audacious enough to change the name in his honor. In quite different but convergent ways, the aim of these two institutions much contribute to the building up of good science all over the world, especially all over the developing world. In many activities, we are convergent, including, as mentioned before by David, we have created in both institutions very prestigious prizes with the idea of giving identity, scientific value to the best scientists in the developing world. Our dream is to see good science all over the developing world. It is not enough to say it only once. We have to keep telling us that we have to be inclusive. Our dream is to see this taking place in an increasing number of countries and to be there to stimulate and help to increase the confidence of local talent scientists to improve the magical ambience that helps to create great science. And we should be recognizing as much as possible the value of the local scientists. Again, it's not a coincidence that both institutions are integrated by passionate people. From the beginning, ICTP has halted to us. And we believe that there is a new opportunity to enhance this collaboration. TWAS draws its strengths from electing the best scientists in the developing world, including the least developed ones, as much as possible. They now number about 850 scientists. There are also about 100 associate fellows from the north or the rich countries or whatever, the developed countries, outstanding scientists like David and others, many others here, that have contributed and continue to contribute to our dream, the basic dream of these two institutions, to have excellent science all over the world. Altogether, after 27 years, TWAS have reached the 1,000 membership threshold. ICTP, pursuing the same cause of science in the South, in several wonderful ways. It's extremely successful, as pointed out before. Like the in-house programs of high-level research involving selected postdoctoral fellows, normally, but not only, from the developing countries. The seminars, workshops, and schools on an array of areas in physics, mathematics, and otherwise, in other branches of science. I learned just today that, or let's say last night, that some 60 of them shall take place in 2011. Is to be mentioned the excellent diploma program that has proven already to be extremely successful. And this is because it has produced already outstanding talent, young people, young scientists. Now it's mature enough, so ICTP is wisely moving to a doctoral program to be established soon. Both ICTP and TUAS are increasingly enlarging its activity in the world at large, forging some decentralization. This is very important. Both institutions are creating, other institutions similar with similar activities or regional offices. Like TUAS has now regional offices in Brazil, China, India, and others. In fact, to be precise, Egypt and Kenya. All of them very successful. The idea is not only to spread the name of TUAS and ICTP all over the world, but also, it's very important to draw on the potential support of the emerging powers of today, which is already happening. So we have to draw on the support of Brazil, China, India, as well as Mexico, Chile, and so on. Along this line, TUAS is extremely open to this new policy. It has been a number of years. And also, I must say, ICTP is going along the same lines and for a number of years. And both are, as I said, developing new roads to get the full involvement of the most knowledge-based nations in the South. Still, much more is to be done to the cause of science in our countries for the benefit of our societies, especially in the poorest countries, which are also the most scientific lagging ones. The correlation is obvious. We don't need, as I said, the statistics and very deep thoughts to find this out. Nevertheless, I'll mention just a few facts. These poorest countries, about 80 of them in the world, they generate less than 1% of the scientific articles published in the internationally peer-reviewed journals. And yet, their population amounts to one-fourth of the world as a whole. 2.5 billion. So we have to continue our efforts to shrink this gap between the scientific capable countries and the scientific lagging ones. And we have to shrink the number of people that cannot live with the benefits of good science and thus good technology. We have to design special activities, special instruments, special initiatives to deal with this very difficult problem, to reach the least developed countries. I wish to conclude by praising again the vision and social wisdom of the Italian government, as well with other agents and institutions that have been greatly supporting ICTP as well as to us, as well as the emerging countries that are offering more and more support to the same activities. And we should work with the customary full enthusiasm to help to ensure that our dream can be finally realized in full. Thank you very much.